Techno is tagging the Phantom S bold and extraordinary. I don't know about extraordinary, but the design of the device certainly looks bold. Well, maybe it's time we get to see what is really extraordinary about the Techno Phantom S from the inside. From the outside, there are so many things to love about this device. This is the Inside Man welcoming you to the teardown video of the Phantom S. If this is your first time here, please hit the subscribe button and turn on post notifications. There are at least two things I'd like to see from inside of the phone. One, the laser focus, and two, the 50 megapixel main camera sensor. Now, let's get to the phone and serious part. Everything about this phone seems to be really good. The curved screen is nice, the design looks great, and it feels premium, but the price is not that good. In case you don't already know, the price of this device is about 228,000 naira. That is about $550. Makes me wonder if this device is actually worth the price. Contrary to what many might have thought, the back cover of this device is glass, but it's just a regular glass that shatters with ease. Well, Jerry has always made us to accept the fact that glass is glass and glass breaks. As you can see, mine just broke, and it will cost me about $36 to get a new back cover for the device. One more thing, if you own this device, it's best to use a protective case for the back. From what I can see, the glass of the back won't survive a single fall. The inside of the phone looks pretty familiar, with the main speaker at the bottom of the device. There is no water-resistant proof in the speaker region, and the sound quality from the speaker is pretty normal. I'll talk more about the sound quality and user experience of the speaker later in the video. What you get at the bottom board is very familiar: the USB Type-C port, 3.5 mm jack port with the water damage indicator. And just like the Camo 17 Pro, there are ribbon cables attached to the board. There are a few things that makes a device easy to recommend. One, the durability of the device. Secondly, the longevity, that is the software update. Then if there is a new tech, that is the third thing, the user experience. Then fifth, the performance, and sixth, the price. For durability, I won't say this device is the best. There is no gasket or rubber to prevent water from entering the device. And coupled with the fact that the back plastic breaks easily, you have one more thing to worry about when using the device. So, as you can see, the 3.5 mm jack has no rubber gasket, but there is a water damage indicator to know if it comes in contact with water. About 2 minutes into the teardown video and the inside review of the Phantom S, and I'm yet to see anything really extraordinary. Well, just hold on. You'll get to see some really cool stuff beneath this back cover. Like it or not, the arrangement of the component of the Phantom S is really nice. Everything knows where they fit, and it's easy to spot what is and what is not. Few more ribbon cables out, and it's easy for me to take out the battery. But the battery of this device is 4700 mAh with 33 watt fast charge. I must say, the battery is big and it's bulky. It's not flat like what we saw in the Camo 17 Pro, and it's also heavy. Now, this explains why the device is much heavier than the Camo 17 Pro. This battery won't carry you for days. The phone will last for days, but the 33 watt fast charge can guarantee you a quick recharge when the battery drains. Now, interesting stuff, which is the first fascinating thing you would like to see in this phone, is the bottom of the battery. Beneath the battery is a copper cooling system. This is not something we see very often in a device of this category, but it's really nice for Techno to include a copper cooling system beneath the battery. The Camo 17 Pro and Infinix Note 10 Pro has graphite tapes beneath their batteries instead of copper. This simply means that the battery won't overheat and the phone would get hot from heavy usage. I'll add this to the list of things I've liked about the phone so far. I told you, we'll start seeing fascinating stuff soon. Now, speaking of fascinating, there are two things that's extraordinary about the Phantom S. One is the 50 megapixel main sensor, and two is the laser focus that comes with the phone. Now, the combination of the 50 megapixel main sensor and the laser focus is why this phone can produce incredible picture quality. And when I say incredible picture quality, it's like the picture qualities of this device is almost as the ones you get from premium devices, you know. Now let's take a closer look at the 50 megapixel sensor. From what I can see, is as if the 50 megapixel sensor is even bigger than the 64 megapixel sensor we've seen in previous devices. It's as big as the 108 megapixel sensor we saw in the Redmi Note 10 Pro. Now this camera does not have OIS, but it has ultra steady video mode. As far as photography and videography goes, you can't go wrong with this device. Night pictures and daytime pictures are all good to go with the camera. This is the laser focus. This tiny little thing here is what makes the 50 megapixel sensor very useful, and it is why the photo quality of this device is as good as what you get from the premium mid-range devices out there. But even with the laser focus, there is no OIS, and you can only enjoy steady video when recording 1080p videos at 30 frames per second. The 4K video mode does not support ultra steady video, which is not that cool. Now, the cooling of the processor is also very impressive. Now, the device uses the MediaTek Helio G95 and is always good to keep the temperatures of gaming processors down. Now, I'm really impressed with what the Tecno has done with the cooling system. It's nice for you to have a device that you can multitask with continually without having to be afraid of it getting hot or feeling it's going to blow up or something like that. The other cameras in this device are not that useful. You have a telephoto and an ultra wide. Then the 48 megapixel main camera up front is also pretty normal. But the choice of chipset of this device is one reason why it is very difficult to recommend this device. The Camon 17 Pro and Infinix Note 10 Pro uses same chipset, and they are about $200 cheaper. So the question is, why spend $550 to buy a device when you can get a $350 device that gives you same performance? Now back to the speakers. This phone only has one solid speaker, which is at the bottom, and the sound quality is great, like I said earlier. But if you are playing games, then your hands might just cover the bottom speaker and won't actually enjoy it that much. Thank God there's a 3.5mm jack, but my point is, better stereo speaker would have greatly improved the sound quality of this device. So far, I can say the Phantom S is bold, but it is not extraordinary. For the bold, the design is impressive, the 50 megapixel main camera is really good, and the laser focus is impressive. And the cooling system inside is top notch, but there is nothing extraordinary inside. I mean, it's not the first time we are seeing a curved AMOLED display. I'll tell you what, the only thing that is extraordinary about the Phantom S is the price. $550 for this device is overpriced. For example, the Galaxy A72 is water resistant and you get 3 software updates, and it's cheaper. The Camon 17 Pro and Infinix Note 10 Pro uses the same chipset, and it's $200 cheaper. The Redmi Note 10 Pro comes with a 108 megapixel sensor, an AMOLED display, 120Hz refresh rate, and it's $200 cheaper. The list goes on and on. So far, the Phantom S only checked few boxes when it comes to what really makes a good device. A new tech, the laser focus at 50 megapixel is nice. The durability is questionable because there's no water resistant and the back glass is it breaks easily. The longevity of the device is not that much impressive. Tecno has not promised any major software update for the Phantom S. It's almost as if everything the Phantom S can do, there are 4 or 5 more other devices that can do same and even perform better at a cheaper price. So, I think Tecno should have focused more on spending money in durability, performance, tech, and reducing the price of the device instead of funding lots of celebrities to promote the device. It feels like the users are paying for the promotion of the device. That is why this device is overly priced. Will I recommend for anyone to buy this device? Not really. I recommend you look the way of the likes of Galaxy A72, Redmi Note 10 Pro first. You can save about $200 doing so and also get to enjoy the device for a longer time. The Phantom S is a bold device with extraordinary price tag. Hopefully, this device won't be this expensive in other regions. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on post notifications. It's me, the Inside Man, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye for now.